Hello everyone, in this video we will see how mechanical optical comparator works along with basic working principle behind optical comparators and their advantages and disadvantages. Mechanical optical comparator. This is also termed as Cook's optical comparator. As the name of the comparator itself suggests, this has a mechanical part and an optical part. Let us first look at the working principle of optical comparator to understand it better. In an optical comparator, a light source and a reflecting surface such as mirror are used as the optical means. An incident ray will hit the mirror and gets reflected, and this ray will be projected on the scale. If we keep the mirror horizontal and project an incident ray OA at an angle theta to the mirror, then it will get reflected with the same angle theta. The mirror can be tilted, where the tilting of the mirror can be controlled by the measuring plunger. This movement will be projected on the graduated scale. So that if the mirror tilts an angle alpha, then the movement in the reflected ray will be angle 2 alpha. This is the working principle of optical comparators. Since you have got an idea about working principle of optical comparators, now we will see how the mechanical optical comparator works. Mechanical optical comparator is same as optical comparator, but the plunger in the mechanical optical comparator will be replaced with the pivoted lever. Working principle of mechanical optical comparator. The lever acts as the plunger. The mirror is connected to the lever mechanism, which is held by the pivot point. Small displacement of the measuring plunger is initially amplified by a lever mechanism pivoted about a point. The mechanical system causes a plane reflector to tilt about its pivot. The plunger is spring-loaded such that it is biased to exert a downward force on the work part. This bias also enables both positive and negative readings depending on whether the plunger is moving up or down. A beam of light passes through a condenser lens that condenses the beam of light, which helps in rendering of sharper image. A condensed beam of light passes through an index. This image is projected by a projection lens onto the plane mirror. The mirror in turn reflects this image onto the inner surface of the ground glass screen, which has a scale. The scale is set to zero by inserting a reference gauge below the plunger. Now the reference gauge is taken out and the work part is introduced below the plunger. As the workpiece slides below the plunger, deviation on the workpiece surface causes a small displacement of the plunger, which is amplified by the mechanical lever. The amplified mechanical movement is further amplified by the optical system due to tilting of the plane reflector. The amplification of the comparator is in the two stages. First, mechanical amplification, which is equal to L2 by L1. Second, optical amplification, which is equal to 2 L4 by L3. The multiplication factor 2 in the optical amplification is because if the mirror is tilted by theta, then the image is tilted by 2 theta over the scale. Thus, overall magnification of the system is equal to optical magnification into mechanical magnification, which is equal to 2 into L4 by L3 into L2 by L1. This is how mechanical optical comparator works. Now let us see the advantages and disadvantages of optical comparators. Advantages. 1. Higher accuracy will be achieved since it is having very less moving parts. 2. Parallax error will be avoided since the scale can be made to move past a datum line without having any parallax error. 3. Less weight compared to other comparators due to fewer parts. 4. Very suitable for precision measurement due to higher magnification. Disadvantages. 1. Needs a separate electrical source. 2. Optical parts are expensive. 3. They have built-in illuminating device which tends to hit the instrument. 4. Eyepiece type instrument may cause strain on the operator. 5. When the scale is projected on a screen, then it is essential to take the instrument to a dark room in order to take the reading easily. Hope you have understood the working of mechanical optical comparator. If you are new to ADTW, consider subscribing this channel to get interesting videos like this. And if you like this video, click on the like button and share with your friends. Also, you can add your opinion in the comment section to let me know what you think about this video. Thank you for watching this video till the end.